हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर केशव, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ AISSMS, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, पुणे। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन मेथड ओवर राइडिंग एंड डायनेमिक मेथड डिस्पैच इन जावा। गोइंग टू इन डिटेल्स ऑफ द मेथड ओवर राइडिंग एंड डायनेमिक डिस्पैच, वी मस्ट नो द पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म। वॉट इज मीन बाय पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म? पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म मीन्स वन इंटू मेनी फॉर्म्स। Don't be confused here, method overriding and method overloading. Method overloading means same method name with different parameters, but method overriding means the method name and parameters also same in a parent class as well as child class. The method overriding is the one of the most important concept in a Java for to achieve the runtime polymorphism. And dynamic method dispatch is the mechanism by which a call to an overridden method is resolved at runtime rather than compile time. As we know, there are two types of polymorphism: compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. When an overridden method is called through a superclass, reference or parent class, Java determines which version. Which version means parent class method version or child class method version is used of that method is to be executed based upon the type of the object being referred at the time of call occur. This determination is made at the runtime. That's why it is called the runtime polymorphism. At runtime, it depends on the type of object being referred. Means it is object of parent class or it is object of child class or super class or subclass. Not the type of the reference variable, means which variable you are referring. That determines which version of the overridden method will be executed. It is parent or child. Superclass reference variable can refer to a subclass object. This is also known as upcasting. Java uses this fact to resolve call to overridden method at the runtime. What is method overriding? We'll little bit discuss on that. In a class hierarchy in a Java, when a method in a subclass has the same name and the type signature as a method in a superclass, then the method in a subclass is said to be override the method in a superclass. In simple word, we can say the name of the method or signature. Signature means with the parameters. If the same in a parent class as well as child class or super class as well as subclass, then the subclass method is called the overridden method. When an overridden method is called from within the its subclass, it will always refer to the version of that method defined by the subclass. The version of the method defined by the superclass will be hidden, or we can say the overridden by the subclass method. This is a small example here, the method overriding. A class A with the two variables int I and j. Here we have written the one method, or we can say the constructor A, int A and int B. And then we initializing the variable I and j with the value of A and B. Display or show I and j, while show System.out.println I and j we are printing here. Okay. Then here class B extends class A. I mean this is a method overriding is comes under in a picture with the inheritance. Okay. And depends upon extend means we are this is your parent class, this is your child class. Then int k b int. This is your constructor or parametric constructor here. Int A, B, int C, then super AB. As we last lecture, we learned the super. When we say the super AB means it is called the constructor of parent class. Okay, and then K equal to C. Here, again, we display the value of K. We have written here the method show, void show, system.out.println. Class override public static void main string args b sub ob. We have created the object of b class, our child class is sub ob, and we have located the memory and initialized also 1, 2, 3 value is 1 and 2 a and b, sorry, I and j, and k is the child class. Sub ob dot show, this is show the value in a b. The output produced by this program is shown here k3, because we have overridden the method. What is the dynamic method dispenser? Method overriding forms the basis of one of the Java's most powerful concept, dynamic method dispatch. Dynamic method dispatch is the mechanism by which a call to an overridden method is resolved at runtime rather than compile time. Or your dynamic method dispatch decides the runtime polymorphism. Dynamic method dispatch is important because this is how Java implements runtime polymorphism. Okay, the another here we know the runtime polymorphism of the C++, but what exactly in a Java? Let us begin by restating an important principle. The superclass reference variable can refer to a subclass object. Java uses this fact to resolve call to overridden method at runtime. For understanding, we'll go through some of the code. When an overridden method is called through a superclass or parent class, Java determines which version of that method is executed based upon the type of object being referred, means object of object class or parent class. Thus, this determines is made at the runtime. When different types of objects are referred to, different versions of an overridden method will be called based upon the object. In other words, it is the type of object being referred to that determine which version of an overridden method will be executed. It is overridden method of parent class or overridden method of child class, because method name is same in a both child as well as parent. Therefore, if a superclass contains method that is overridden by subclass or child class, then when different type of objects are referred to through a superclass reference variable, different version of method are executed. Just see, here is the small example of dynamic method dispatch. Class A, void call me, the function is called, then it is printing the inside A call me method is called. Then class B extend from the A, B is the child and A is the parent class. Then again we override the method call me. If you just see here, void call me and void call me, but where only this we are printing the inside the B call me method, so we can understand which method is called. Then class C extend from the A. Okay, again we call the same method name void call me, and we printing here inside the call me method or C. Here we are going to test our program. Call dispatch, public static void main string, this is the main function of Java. Then we have created the three objects of class A, class B and class C. Okay, then AR, okay, obtain reference of type A. Then R equal to A, here A is the object and R refers to an object A. R dot call, okay, calls A's version of call me, because the reference of object of the class A. Then we say the R equal to B, then when we call the R dot call, it will be called the B class version, so it will be print the second. First call me or R dot call me will be print the inside A call me, then R equal to B, when we call the R dot call me, okay, so this will be executed, so it will be display on the screen is inside the B call me method. And when we R equal to C, and when we again call the R, when these are the R is a reference variable for the C class or this child class, so it will print inside the C. In this way, your method overriding and method dispatch is worked, or dynamic method dispatch in Java. Happy learning.